Yes. How are you, everybody?
Nice.
सर अस्सलाम वालेकुम सर।
वालेकुम सलाम। टुडे आई हैव टू स्टार्ट अगेन ब्रीफिंग ऑन पाकिस्तान। And today's lecture or briefing will upload on YouTube. You can get lecture from YouTube. I will give you complete briefing on Pakistan. And if I have some time, so we have short question answers. And tomorrow is test. I want to tell you one thing, that self-introduction. And interview and Pakistan will make the part of test tomorrow. Let I start. Briefing on Pakistan. As usual, main points. According to main points, you can speak well. You can reply me according to main points easily. Again, I write again. Yesterday, I also wrote here, but instead of I write again today, just for your practice. Definition. Background. This point was skipped yesterday. Background. Background means past. Importance. Problems. Tragedies. Achievements. Point of view. You have to write all main points. Did you note everybody?
Yes, sir.
Let us start.
Sir, 7 pointer.
Number 7 is point of view.
Point of view. Suggestions.
Okay, it's missed. Okay.
Sir.
Okay, thank you very much.
And background, as you said, you didn't return background.
Okay, I have to write here. Miss this one now. Yesterday, you know, I have noted it now. So there are many points today. Number 7 suggestion. Why not? I agree with you. Suggestion.
So background.
Noted. Number 2. Background is there. Suggestions. Suggestions. S-U-G-G. Suggestions. Number 8 point of view. Let us start. Briefing on Pakistan. First of all, definition. Pakistan is Muslim country. Pakistan got independence on 14th August in 1947. Pakistan made on the basis of Kalma. Qaid Azam is the founder of Pakistan. Khan Lakhdar Khan is the first prime minister of Pakistan. The national language of Pakistan is Urdu. The national dress of Pakistan is shalwar suit. Pakistan has four provinces. The old capital of Pakistan was Karachi. The latest capital of Pakistan is Islamabad. Pakistan has four seasons. There are two colors of flag of Pakistan. The green color shows that Muslims are in majority in Pakistan, and white color shows minority or non-Muslims in Pakistan. There is also moon and star on the flag of Pakistan. Moon means prosperity and the star means success. It is simple, no definition of Pakistan. Second point, background. How Pakistan made? What were circumstances? What was situation? In what was situation, circumstances? In which circumstances Pakistan made? Circumstances. In the subcontinent, there were two main nations. Subcontinent. In the subcontinent, there were two main nations. Hindus and Muslims were two main nations in the subcontinent. Muslims ruled in the subcontinent for many centuries. Many centuries. Muslims ruled in the subcontinent for many centuries. Muslims ruled in the subcontinent for many years. In 1857, British rulers captured the subcontinent. It was machination.
Sir, can I say a question now?
It was machination.
Kadre kawa pakhtay. Shwag bhai mera kali dey.
Your mic is on, bro.
Be quiet, please. Be quiet. You can discuss after the lecture. It was machination against Muslims. Hindus cooperated with British rulers because Hindus were against the Muslims. So Hindus cooperated with British rulers and welcomed them in the subcontinent. Hindus learned English language and Hindus got good jobs and got prosperity. On the other hand, Muslims hated from British rulers and also hated from English language. At that time, Muslims were very hopeless. There was hopelessness in the Muslims. Muslims were very disappointed. They had not hope. There was darkness. At that time, Sir Syed Ahmed Khan observed this situation. Muslims were victim of poverty. And at that time, Sir Syed Ahmed Khan wrote many books and told to Muslims that since when you don't learn English language, you can't get prosperity. For this purpose, he opened Aligarh College, Aligarh University. Sir Syed Ahmed Khan played major role and he encouraged to Muslims that Muslims have to hate from British rulers but don't hate from English language. For this purpose, he opened Aligarh College and Aligarh University. A large number of Muslims learned English language and got higher education. Then All Pakistan Muslim League met. All Pakistan Muslim League passed the resolution on 23rd March in 1923. Then Pakistan resolution started and Pakistan movement started and Pakistan got independence by struggle on 14th August in 1947. Pakistan resolution was passed on 23rd March in 1940, not 1923, 1940. And Pakistan got independence on 14th August in 1947. All Pakistan Muslim League realized to British rulers why Pakistan is important. Qaid Azam was the president of All Pakistan Muslim League. He told to British rulers that Hindus and Muslims are two different nations and nothing was matching among Hindus and Muslims. He told to Muslims it is impossible to stay together for Muslims and Hindus in the subcontinent. So British rulers understood this point and by teamwork, by unity, Pakistan got independence on 14th August in 1947. There was nothing sameness among Muslims and Hindus in any matter. Religion was different, dressing was different, food was different, lifestyle was different, culture was different. A to Z, everything was quite opposite. So it was, you know, it was not possible to stay together for Muslims and Hindus in the subcontinent. It was a background of Pakistan. Importance, why Pakistan is important for us? First of all, our forefathers offered many sacrifices for Pakistan. We can't ignore the sacrifices from our forefathers. On the other hand, we born in Pakistan. We got early education in Pakistan. We spent our childhood in Pakistan. We do jobs in Pakistan. We do business in Pakistan. We have freedom in Pakistan. We have liberty in Pakistan. We have our separate ID cards as a Pakistani. We have our separate passports as a Pakistani. We have our separate identity as a Pakistani in the world. So Pakistan is very important for us as a Pakistani. Nobody can go to Pakistan. Pakistan has great importance for us as a Pakistani. Pakistan is very important for us as a Pakistani. Problems. Pakistan has many problems because Pakistan is underdeveloped country. Pakistan is poor country. First of all, Pakistan is illiterate country. Mostly people are uneducated in Pakistan because a large number of people live in the villages. The 70% people, 70% people live in the villages. In the villages, not educational facilities, not many schools, not many colleges, not many universities, not many academies, not many institutes. So mostly people are illiterate in Pakistan. Mostly people are without education in Pakistan. So basic problem, major problem is illiteracy in Pakistan. Other problem, I talk about water problem in Pakistan. Water problem, because we have few dams in Pakistan. There is problem of health in Pakistan. We have few hospitals in Pakistan. We have not proper medical facilities in Pakistan. We have few hospitals. We have few doctors. Mostly people die without treatment. On the other hand, there is overpopulation. Population is too much. We have less sources. Our sources are less, but our demands are too much. We are facing the problem of load shedding. We have sewage gas problem. The law and order situation is not good in Pakistan. Pakistan is also a victim of terrorism. Pakistan is also a corrupt country. Corruption is going on peak in Pakistan. Most people do fraud. Mostly people are busy in cheating. The recommendations and bribe is very common in Pakistan. So, on the other hand, there is also a problem of unemployment. Mostly people have not jobs in Pakistan. Most people are jobless in Pakistan. Most people are without jobs in Pakistan. So unemployed people have to start crimes, different crimes. So there are many problems in Pakistan. There are countless problems in Pakistan. There are numberless problems in Pakistan. There are a lot of problems in Pakistan. Next point, tragedies. When Pakistan got independence on 14th August 1947, after independence of, you know, Pakistan, after independence of Pakistan, after 1 year in 1948, two tragedies took place. First of all, Qaid-e Azam was died on 11th September 1948. In the same year, Pakistan lost Kashmir. In 1951, Khan Lakhdari Khan, as the first Prime Minister of Pakistan, was killed at Shaukat Bagh in Rawalpindi. In 1971, Pakistan broke in two parts. Pakistan lost East Pakistan. Further tragedies. On 8th October in 2005, earthquake came in Pakistan. and mostly people were died as a result. It was severe loss of precious lives. Further tragedies, in 1979, Zulfikar Ali Bhutto was hang up in a fake murder case. Zulfikar Ali Bhutto was Prime Minister of Pakistan, and he, during his government, Pakistan started atomic program. On 16th December in 2014, APS attack took place in KPK by terrorists, and a large number of students were died. As a result, all students were soldiers for future. So it was attack on future of Pakistan. These were all tragedies. Now, achievements of Pakistan. First of all, Pakistan made, it is God gifted. Pakistan made on the base of Kalma. Pakistan made during the holy month of Ramadan. Further, Pakistan started, Pakistan won the war with India in 1965. Pakistan defeated to India in the war of 1965. India is big country and Pakistan is small country. Instead of Pakistan defeated to India. In 1974, Pakistan started atomic program. Malala Yousafzai played major role in education sector as a Pakistani girl. Certainly it was achievement on world level. She was appreciated as a Pakistani girl. Arifa Karim made world record in the field of IT. She made software just in the age of 16 years, and her name was written in the Guinness Book of World Record. And she had belonged from Pakistan. As a Pakistani girl, she performed well, and certainly it was an achievement as a Pakistani girl. Pakistan won the Cricket World Cup in 1992 under the supervision of latest Prime Minister of Pakistan, Imran Khan. Pakistan made world champion in hockey. Pakistan made world champion in hockey. Pakistan made world champion in squash. Further, you know that, yes, on 28th May in 1998, Pakistan did 7 atomic experiments, and Pakistan, you know, made atomic power in Muslim world. Certainly it was achievement. It was also achievement that India did 5-7 atomic experiments. On the other hand, as a reply, Pakistan did 7 atomic experiments. So these were all achievements. Now suggestions. How we can go to Pakistan? How we can progress to Pakistan? Suggestions. First of all, we should respect our country. We should not speak against our country. We should work for Pakistan with honesty. We should ready for all sacrifices for Pakistan. We should act on teachings of Islam as a Muslim. Then we can make good Pakistani. Further things, that we need teamwork, we need unity. We should not show our selfishness. We should not be selfish. We should be positive minded. We should not be negative minded. We need work and more work for Pakistan. We should follow to Holy Quran, and we should follow to Holy Prophet, peace be upon him. What are things that we have to work, we need work with unity, faith and discipline, as Catechism said. And as Catechism said that we need work, work and more work if we want get prosperity. If we have to make advanced country, okay, in the world. These are all suggestions. And now in my point of view, Pakistan is everything for us. And we should ready for all sacrifices for Pakistan. As a Pakistani, we should care about Pakistan. Certainly freedom is, freedom is God gifted, and we should care about our freedom, and we should ready for all sacrifices for Pakistan, is my point of view. I have to close my briefing here. Now also I have to start question answers, because it's also preparation for your test tomorrow. So if you have to know about it now, so you have to reply me. According to question, you have to reply me. Your answer should be according to my question. You should not go in detail. You should not go in unnecessary detail. To the point, I need answer. First of all, I ask from all of you, in which holy month Pakistan made?
In Ramadan.
Complete answer I needed now. It's not like quiz.
Pakistan came into being in the holy month of Ramadan.
Certainly, quite right. Okay. How many provinces of Pakistan?
There are 4 provinces in Pakistan.
Yes, of course. You have to tell me that why Pakistan is important for us. What is the importance of Pakistan for us? You can reply me in 3 to 4 lines, anyone.
Pakistan is very important for us because we born in Pakistan. We have separate identity card. We can move anywhere. We can pray our salah, and we can, nobody can stop us. We can.
Yeah. Of course. Okay, I ask you that what happened in 1857 in the subcontinent?
In 1857, British rulers came in subcontinent and captured the all subcontinent.
Of course. You have to show me. Can you tell me that what was the attitude of Hindus towards British rulers? What was attitude by Hindus? Anyone knows about it?
They were with British government.
Hindus cooperated with British rulers. Hindus showed positive attitude for British rulers. The attitude of Hindus was positive for British rulers. Hindus welcome to British rulers in the subcontinent. Got it now? I ask you.
Got it.
Why Muslims hated from English language? Why Muslims hated from English language?
Sir, because they are English, and they can capture the subcontinent. And they also hated from British people.
Yes. Anyone can reply me? Why Hindus? I tell you one thing, that you don't care about it, that you have to speak wrong English or good English, but you have to speak in this class. I have to remove your hesitation. You don't care about it, that you have to speak wrong English or correct English, incorrect or correct English. Don't care about it, but you have to speak. It is language now. Along with time, you have to improve yourself. Yes.
Muslim hate the English language because of the negative role of British government.
Okay. Right. Right. Okay. Anyone? Anyone can explain it now? Same question.
Sir, they are not Muslim.
Okay, everybody, okay, tried well. I tell you one thing. Because English was the language of British rulers. So Muslims hated from English language. Because English language was the language of British rulers. It was the reason behind. So Muslims also hated from English language. You tell me that what did Sir Syed Ahmed Khan for Muslims? Can anyone tell me? Yes, Kainat. Not there? Yes, Jaleel. Anyone can apply me? Abdul Jaleel. And further, yes. Yes. Yes, yes.
Pakistan, Sir Syed Ahmed Khan gives a two nation theory for Muslims that Muslims is a separate nation from Indian, from Hindus.
Yes. Sir Syed Ahmed Khan, he also did it. I agree with you that he told that Muslims and Hindus are two nations. Further, what he did, as I briefed you today in my lecture. I mean,
Aligarh College, sir.
He made Aligarh College. For Aligarh University for Muslims. Further,
and he also tell Muslims that don't get interest in politics.
He gave message to Muslims. Sayyid Ahmed Khan gave message to Muslims that you. Don't hate from English language. You hate from British rulers, but you don't hate from English language. Did you get my point now? Very simple answer.
Got it.
By writings,
got it,
sir. By writings, Sir Syed Ahmed Khan told to Muslims that Muslims, if Muslims want their basic rights and if Muslims got prosperity, then Muslims have to learn English language. And he said Muslims hate from British rulers, but don't hate from English language. It was message by Sir Syed Ahmed Khan. Yes, next question I ask you, what is the main or major problem in Pakistan? Who will tell me? What is the main problem in Pakistan?
The main and major problem of Pakistan is there is no job for youngsters, for the youth. And another is there is no education in the village sites.
No. Don't go in detail. Just I asked about major or main problem in Pakistan. One problem, main problem.
Education, sir.
Yeah. Illiteracy.
Illiteracy, yes, sir.
Illiteracy is the main or major problem in Pakistan. Yes, I ask you next question. Pakistan is, Pakistan is underdeveloped country or advanced country?
Underdeveloped country, sir.
Pakistan is underdeveloped country. Why not? Pakistan is underdeveloped country. Okay. I ask you next question. You have to tell me that in the subcontinent, among Hindus and Muslims, what thing was common among Muslims and Hindus?
Traditions and culture, sir.
Okay. Nothing was matching. Nothing was missing among Muslims and Hindus. Nothing was matching. Okay, you have to tell me that who was the founder of Pakistan and who is the founder? Yes. Yes, tell me.
So can you repeat the question?
Who was the founder of Pakistan?
Qadi Azam Muhammad Ali Jinnah is the founder of Pakistan.
Qadi Azam Muhammad Ali Jinnah was founder of Pakistan. Can you tell me about the death of Qadi Azam? What was the date of death of Qadi Azam? Anyone?
September 25, 1948.
Yes, anyone? Anyone? Yes. Qadi Azam was died on 11 September in 1948. Qadi Azam was died on 11 September in 1948. What happened in 1951?
So in 1951, Khan Liaquat Khalil Khan was killed in Liaquat Bagh.
Good. Yes. What happened in 1979?
Zulfiqar Ali Bhutto was hanged up in a fake murder case.
Good. What happened on 28th May in 1998?
It's a Yom-e Takbir. Pakistan has exploded atomic bomb.
Certainly.
In Chaghi.
Yes. Pakistan made as atomic power on 28th May in 1998 by 7 atomic experiments at Chaghi in Balochistan. Good. Next, I ask you, what happened in 1992?
Pakistan had won the World Cup, ICC World Cup.
Certainly. Who was captain?
Imran Khan.
Imran Khan was captain of Pakistan cricket team. And he is the latest Prime Minister of Pakistan. I ask you next question. What happened in 1974?
1974, sir.
What happened in 1974? What happened in 1974?
Sir, Pakistan broke in two parts.
Oh my God. Allah will keep safe to Pakistan. What happened in 1974? Pakistan started atomic program in 1974. Pakistan started atomic program in 1974.
And the supervision was Zulfiqar Ali Bhutto.
What happened in 1971?
Pakistan broke into two parts.
Yes, now it is correct answer. Now, Pakistan broke into two parts. Pakistan lost East Pakistan in 1971. I ask you next question. You have to tell me that what is the national language of Pakistan?
Sir, Urdu is the language of Pakistan.
Yes, Urdu is the national language of Pakistan. Wait. You have to tell me that how many colors of flag of Pakistan?
So there are two colors flag of Pakistan, green and white.
Okay. What do you mean by green color?
White color represent the minority of Pakistan and green color
what
represent
do you
the
mean?
Majority of Pakistan.
Green color means?
Prosperity.
Oh my God. Green color means Muslims are in majority in Pakistan, and white color shows minorities or non-Muslims in Pakistan.
Sir.
And what do you
I have mean first,
by moon and star on flag of Pakistan? What do you mean by moon and star on flag of Pakistan?
Moon means prosperity and star means success.
That's good. Would you like to tell me about it? Who was Afaq Rahim? Who was she?
Yes, sir. Can you repeat?
Who was Afaq Rahim? Who was she? What she did
for a Pakistani girl who made in 16 who made Microsoft in 16 years.
She made software in the age of 16 years, a Pakistani girl. And she made world record. And her name was mentioned or written in the Guinness Book of World Record. Who was Malala Yousafzai?
A girl who representing educational.
Okay. She performed well in the education sector as a Pakistani girl in the world. She worked for education. She encouraged to women in the world regarding education. Okay, you have to tell me. You have to tell me that what happened on 8th October in 2005.
An earthquake comes and destroys many homes.
Certainly. Agree with you. The earthquake came in Pakistan. And as a result, mostly people were died. It was major shock for Pakistan. A large number of people were died as a result of earthquake. Okay. What happened on 16 December in 2014? What happened?
Sir, in 16 December 2014, the terrorist attacked on APS Peshawar and a lot of students were died in that attack.
Okay, quite right. APS attack took place in KPK. Terrorist attacked on APS. And as a result, mostly students were died. I ask you next question. On what base Pakistan made? What is the base of Pakistan? What was the base of Pakistan?
Sir, Karna is the base of Pakistan.
Yeah.
Sir, Kalma is the base of Kalma. Pakistan.
Pakistan made on the base of Kalma. Okay. Can you tell me about problems in Pakistan? Anyone?
The major problem of Pakistan is illiteracy, shortage of jobs,
okay,
load shedding.
Okay.
Lack of water in many cities.
Okay.
Enough, sir.
Pakistan has many problems as an underdeveloped country. First of all, Pakistan has major problem of illiteracy, our population, few dams, unemployment, our population, crimes are too much. Corruption, health problem. So Pakistan has many problems. These are basics, basic problems. These are basic needs for public. But mostly people have not basic needs in Pakistan. Why Pakistan is illiterate country? What is the reason behind now? Why Pakistan is illiterate country? What is the reason behind?
Because the majority of peoples of Pakistan lives in village, villages side.
Why not?
There is no there is no such a good schools, universities and colleges. That's why.
Certainly, I agree with you. Because a large number of people live in the villages. 70% people live in the villages. So there are not educational facilities. And there in villages, not many schools, not many colleges, not many universities, not many academies, and not many institutes. On the other hand, fee is too much. Most people can't afford the fee. Fee is not affordable for people. There is an unemployment problem in Pakistan. There is poverty. The law and order situation not good in Pakistan. What are the things? Corruption is going on peak in Pakistan. Muslim people are not united. Pakistanis are not united. People have to speak against Pakistan. Terrorism is also common. Also, there is too much Pakistan. Pakistan is victim of overpopulation. We have few sources. We have less sources. Pakistan is not, most people have not basic needs. Okay. Can you tell me about benefits of Pakistan? We live in Pakistan and what benefits we have to enjoy in Pakistan now? I did not mention about it, but I will tell you verbally, got it now, no problem.
Sir, we have separate identities and we can move easily to other cities and sir, we are freely allowed in our country. And we can find job easily here because we are Pakistanis. We have identity of Pakistan.
These okay. are
benefits of benefits. Pakistan for us.
Okay.
And we can trade here easily.
Yeah. Okay. Good try. First of all, we have liberty in Pakistan.
Liberty means, sir?
We can enjoy our lives. We are independent in Pakistan. We can do jobs in Pakistan. We can do business in Pakistan. We can go anywhere in Pakistan. We can spend our lives according to our choice in Pakistan. Third things that we can prove ourselves by hard working, by struggle. We have to get our rights in Pakistan. We have respect in Pakistan. And on the other hand, you know that we have our relatives in Pakistan. We, you know that we have our friends in Pakistan. And nobody can stop us. Nobody can bound us. We are, you know that we have actual thing, we have liberty in Pakistan. It's a major and main benefit. If we are independent Pakistan, so we can enjoy our lives according to our choice. We can spend our lives according to our choice. We can avail all facilities in Pakistan. You know, if we do hard work, we can earn much too much money. Okay, if we do work with honesty and hardworking, and if we have to work with struggle, so we can achieve our goals and targets in Pakistan. Nobody will stop us. So already Muslims are in majority in Pakistan. And on the other hand, you know that we can, you know, we can spend our lives according to our choice is the main benefit. And we can prove ourselves. Like I tell you about in the subcontinent, Muslims had not basic rights. You know, when 1857, British rulers captured the subcontinent. Before it, Muslims were very strong. So before 1857, same situation came back in the form of Pakistan. Got it now? The sameness of situation. Okay, I ask you next question. I ask you have, can you tell me how we can promote to Pakistan? I need your suggestions. How we can promote to Pakistan? How we can progress to Pakistan? I need your suggestions or proposals, ideas.
We can promote Pakistan by recruiting the youngsters, by developing more factories and industries for jobs, by exploring in the tourism.
Why not?
Enough, sir.
Okay, good try. First of all, government should focus attention towards the education sector. Many schools should open in the villages. Government and private sector should focus attention towards the education sector, first of all. First of all, we have to solve our major problem. I mean to say, we have to solve the problem of education, first of all. We have to control to illiteracy, and we have to change illiteracy. We have changed illiteracy to literacy. We have to educate to people. First of all, we have to solve this major problem. On the other hand, government have to make many dams. Then we can solve the problem of drinking water, and we can avoid from problem of load shedding. But I think that many jobs opportunities should create in the country. Then unemployment can decrease. Very important suggestion that by all means, all Pakistanis have to learn English language. I want to tell you one thing, that if mostly people have to learn English language, so most people can get good jobs on offer letters. First of all, I tell you about very important thing. Why Pakistan made, how Pakistan made. First of all, Pakistan is God gifted, I don't deny. First of all, Pakistan is God gifted. On the other hand, Muslims learned English language, and Muslims convinced to British rulers why Pakistan was important. And British rulers understood the point of view of Muslims in English. So then you can understand, if Pakistan can make by this language, why not you can achieve your goals just by English language? Did you get your point now? The best suggestion, good suggestion for you. If you want get prosperity, and if you want progress, if you want development, so by all means, you have to learn English language. Instead of, I tell you one thing, if you do masters in different subjects, but you can't speak English, you are not perfect in English language, you can't get good job, I give you guarantee, you will apply for job of peon. It is not good sign. On the other hand, somebody is matriculate and they have to learn English language, I give you guarantee, matriculate can good job on offer letter in Pakistan, and he can earn too much money. It is best suggestion for you. We can develop to Pakistan, we can promote to Pakistan, we can work for Pakistan. People have to get prosperity. Then overall, Pakistan will progress rapidly, quickly, or fastly. Got it now?
Got it, sir.
Yes. Any question?
Yes.
Regarding today's briefing, it was also practice for your test tomorrow. Got it now? In this way, I will take your test. I will ask you question answers. If do you have any questions, sure, you can ask me regarding Pakistan.
Sir, tell about suggestions.
Okay, I explained about suggestions.
Yes, sir.
Okay, just started now. First of all, we have to act on teachings of Islam, first of all. Then we need teamwork. We should not speak against Pakistan. We should respect our country. If we respect our country, then other people or other countries will respect to Pakistan. On the other hand, we need hard work with honesty for Pakistan. We need teamwork, we need unity. We have to work for Pakistan. We should not be selfish. We should not think about our pockets. We should think about Pakistan. We should stop corruption in Pakistan. Further things, as Kadim said, if we want to get prosperity, then we need work, work, and more work. If we want to get success, we have to work with duty, faith, and discipline. And we have to work joint for Pakistan. We should not depend only on government. We should not see to government only. If you know government and public don't work together, it is impossible that Pakistan have to get progress rapidly, quickly, or fastly. Here are suggestions. Okay. Also, I gave you suggestion that if we want get progress and we can promote to Pakistan, we can, if we want develop to Pakistan, then we have to learn English language by all means. Is a first step and very important step. We have to learn and we have to get command on this language. Okay? No question?
No, sir.
Okay, so inshallah this class will upload on YouTube, and you are also, you can get this class from YouTube. Got it now? So class is going to end now. Wish you good luck. Allah Hafiz.
Thank you, sir. Allah Hafiz.
Welcome. God bless you.